Sometimes you're going to need to retrieve data that's timed to match a certain array of timestamps. For example, this tag right here, CDT158, that's a live process variable. That's something that's maybe it's a temperature transmitter or something like that. Let's pretend that this value right here, this value is some kind of a, let's say a lab result. Let's see if we can come up with a better one. Yeah, here we go. This is a measure of concentration, BA concentration.1. And this is a live process value. Well, concentration is measured, as you can see, about 3 times a day. And it's at even unevenly spaced intervals. It's around, right around noon, around 8 o'clock, around 4 o'clock. So these values are coming in at specific points in time. And all I'd like to do is map my live process value, which normally comes in real time, to these specific times here. Well, there's a way of doing that. Let me go ahead and add CDT158 as the tag name I'm going to retrieve. But now in this case, instead of retrieving sample data or compressed data, we're going to be bringing time data using this as the set of timestamps. I'll go ahead and demonstrate. I'll just click here for my tag name. I'll make reference to that. For my timestamps, though, I'm going to make reference to an array of timestamps. Now, in this case, I'm going to be bringing in interpolated data, which means it's going to get exact values for that point or for those points in time. Yeah, there we go. As you can see, these values are coming in. We don't see any timestamps on them, but they have the same timestamps as these values right here. If we click on this, you can see the relationship between the two. Let me demonstrate another interesting use of that. For example, I'm just going to go ahead and delete that. Let's say that we're not interested in this value right here, these times here. Let's say, again, we're looking for some correlation that may be offset in time. Let's say we think that this is a leading indicator and there's a lagging indicator here in temperature that lags by about, oh, let's say 30 minutes. I can go in here and create an alternate set of timestamps. Let's say that this is equal to that plus, and in this case we'll do, let's go with, that's going to be 1, which is 1 day, divided by 48, that's going to be 30 minutes. There we go. Now that's, of course, in a format that is showing this in, it's actually showing it in integers counting from January 1st, 1900. So let me copy this format over here. That's how Excel renders timestamps. I'll do a paste special. We'll paste the format so that we can see. There we go. That's a little bit better. We can see that this is 11:53. This is 12:23. So it's exactly 30 minutes offset. And if I copy this down, you know, the 1953 becomes 2053, or 2023, 3:53 to 4:23. So these are all exactly half an hour offset. Well, isn't this nice? Now I can go in and do time data based on this tag, but now using this alternate set of timestamps. Time data, here's the tag name. Here are the set of timestamps. The output cell was the default that I had selected first, and there are my results. So now what we're looking at is correlated in time, but offset by 30 minutes. So it's a nice option you can do with this time data. Now one last thing about this time data, let me bring this back up, is we're looking at interpolated values. You can also choose exact time, which is simply going to bring in a value if there is a value exactly at that timestamp. Let's see if there are any values. No, in this case, there are no values for this tag at exactly that timestamp, so we just report that there are no events found. And again, that was, yeah, that was because I had chosen exact time as opposed to interpolated. I've mentioned a couple of times that it's sensible to use cell references instead of hard coding things in these, you know, in these functions, instead of actually hard coding the names, making cell reference. I'll show you a good example of why that could be useful. If I were to switch this around, you know, for example, a different tag, now we get different results here. That's automatically propagating forward to here, and now we're seeing these values here are offset from these values here. Let's try another tag. Yeah, here's different set of timestamps, different set of results here. So in conclusion, whenever you find that there's a series of timestamps, either timestamps coming from Pi or some timestamps you've generated on your own, and you want to retrieve a set of data just for those specific timestamps, that's when you use this time data option.